Sanibonani babukeli bethu ekhaya. Igama lami nguPhindile umntwana wakaJobe and I'm joined today by my lovely co-host, uDelisile, Siyadimo, noNokthula. Hello ladies, how are you doing?
Hey, Siyaphila njani wena?
Ngiyaphila. We all have unique and often memorable stories about going through puberty. We watch our bodies in fascination as they change from childhood through to adolescence and then into adulthood. But this change can sometimes be so scary, but it is necessary. Stay with us tonight as we explore sex, sexuality, and physical development. So ladies, I'm gonna jump straight into it. How did you guys experience your sexuality for the first time?
You know, the first time I had tingly feelings was when I started touching my body, and then me and my friends would start touching each other's bodies. And I mean, that never felt like a real thing, because even when I had my first kiss with a girl, it always felt like this is practice for Harihola and we have to start doing certain things with boys. And I never got to own that first sexual experience with myself.
Okay, I mean, it was with a boy.
Tell us about it.
Okay. My figure, it was first time, it was so.
Yeah.
But I enjoy it. My son figure kai and figure like is. Like, I'm tweeting to a bang boy and I would say, But I really enjoyed it. I went back for more.
Imagine. So, when I was cutting, Nami, I had a first crush. My first crush when I was still at school. That led to my first kiss with that particular guy. Then I started allowing him to touch my genitals and my body, and it was amazing. It was such a beautiful sensation that I was feeling. But then when I went home, ngikhuluma naye kwi-mixit, ngicabanga ngabazali bami belokhu bengitshela ukuthi kumele uziphathe kahle njengentombazane. I began to feel awkward, you know, and doubtful of what I'd done, and I just thought that it was wrong.
Talking about wrong, my first sexual experience and my introduction to sexuality started when I was raped and I was 5 years old. And from that experience, I started to think that sex had to be violent. And I also started to feel very uncomfortable ngomzimba wami, because mankhula mabele, you know, all those things. I started to think, no, people are going to use this as a weapon against me, instead of celebrating it as something that is beautiful. And I think this is some of the things that us as young women, we experience on a daily basis, and no one wants to talk about it. There is a lot of confusion and shame around speaking openly about what occurs naturally in our bodies, development, and sexuality, let alone having to deal with such trauma at such a young age. Let's find out more about this in the following story.
Womanhood, it's like you have reached the stage where usungasho ukuthi I'm fine with everything. I'm fine with myself. Esteme umuntu determine okuningi nama developments asuke ezobe senzekile ese complete kumina. Ngingasho ukuthi ke ngisese stage in sasu puberty because ngisa developer nami. Angikafiki stage ni sokuthi ngisho ukuthi I'm ready to have sex or not, because I'm still finding myself, I could say. Abantu abaningi ba have sex before be ready ngoba befuna ukuthi babe popular esikoleni. Kusuke kuyi peer pressure from friends. Umngani mangabe nisebonile ukuthi seke wa heavy sex, ecabanga ukuthi nomngane wakhe mhlawumbe sikufanele naye a heavy sex nabafana. Besine group ye BEM Jam Club ebisiza nje ingane zonke esikoleni. Sifundisana sodwa sizingane, si-encourage-ane ekuthenini senze ini, fanele singenze ini, kanti futhi besisiza kakhulu naseyinganeni zasesikoleni ukuthi-ke zingathuki nabo uma ngabe ukuthi babone ama-changes, cause vele besesifundisiwe ngakho.
Uma ngabe usebenzisa uyadlula, so bese ubeka kanje, udlule kanje. Ngithi yabo futhi kunobufisha nobude, bese uvula la ama-wings. Uvula ama-wings, uvule nala ehlala khona i-underpant yakho. Bese ubeka kanje. Lokho okufisha kuhlala la ngaphezulu, lokhu kuhlala la ngemuva, lokho kude. Bese uvula, ufaka ama-wings akho la ngaphansi kwephenti lakho kanje. bese kuma kanje nje ngisungashoda ingqondo omkhulu nomsungadali iphindwe indlamu kwenze yonke into oyithandayo.
Njengoba sengihamba la ekhaya ngetheshari, ngi-expect ukuthi ngisocialize kakhulu nabantu ukuze ngizokhona ukufunda izinto ezintsha. Nakhona lokho ngizokufunda kungisize ekuthenini ngikhule kwamina. And futhi kuzobe ngingasekho muntu ola eduze kwami ongigadile ukuthi ngenza ini ngenzi ini. Ilapho sengizokhona khona ukuveza engikufundisiwe ekhaya. Kuyangithusa ukuthi-ke ngihambe. Because abantu abaningi bazongi-intimidate ekuthenini ngenze izinto emina engingabi ready ukuzenza. Into engangitshela yona ukuthi I'll have sex when I'm ready.
You know, ladies, into engichazele kakhulu ngale insert ukubona leya ntombazane ifundisa abanye ukusebenzisa ipad. And that instantly reminded me of the first time that I had my period. So what was it like when you guys first got your periods?
Nagitala the periods, I think I was about from 12, it's a bit alang. I just kilomwaka madi, what's alang? I was on chrono, not alal madi, I do la fadzi. Do la hey, tlamio do la kam chuitzing, pedi genan, tlamio do la fifu sing, tlamio tlam. And so I just felt like it's such an unnatural thing, nilo awkward, nona li secrecy, skajuta tapang hotzing, my little sister. And so it was always attached with shame. It's like it's something I had to be embarrassed with. And niksa chrono kalaba chuitzi baka and just ever since then, just physical development has just been uncomfortable because of how my period started.
Yeah. How did you guys finally become comfortable with your sexuality and your physical development?
I think for me, a turning point yeah, mine, ukuthi mangiqoxa nabangani bami nomuntu wami yabo manje masekameleni uyazi ukuthi ngifunani ngithandani kanjani. And that really started to liberate me and show me that my body wasn't this terrible thing that I should be ashamed of. It was beautiful and needed to be celebrated.
So earlier on, Sibuze amantombazane lawa ahleli nathi ukuthi how do you choose who to have sex with? And these were the answers. So someone who was kind, someone that I love and trust, someone with a good body, and someone with a personality. I think these answers are really cool.
Yeah, they are.
Umasa Sboya will be speaking to Boitumelo Sefolo about sex, sexuality, and physical development. Stay tuned. You do not want to miss this.
About sex. You tell your party, so no condom, no sex.
Reale amohela hape. Ka jono re etetswe ke Aus Boitumelo Sefolo, e leng a clinical psychologist. Dumela Aus tu.
Hello, Kaime.
Aus tu, me kopa go tla ka wena ne. Go na le mnyenyetsi ona o reng. Ha o qala fela o mensa o so le msadi. Nna ke qadile o mensa ke le 12, so what does that even mean?
Go ba msadi, I think, has a stage se leng gore re fitlha mo aging e itseng and then you become a woman. If o ka e lebelela from the legal perspective, once you by 18, but you become an adult again. Adults again, men and women. So that's when you become a woman. How can you from a cultural perspective? Sometimes see kodi culture zedingi bataba lideri dance, but then they welcome you into womanhood again. Modi culture zeding how nyala batari yano musadi utiele again. So someone would say ke musadi kona jano. So musadi bona. Rewna ntse re kena mo bona hantse re tsamaya ka di stages e tlotla go mothong gore wena o ipona o tiya mokae and it changes according to developer joang emotionally o nka dilo joang le ka di bodies a rona ga ditla re start a menstrual cycle
fela re bua ka sex and sexuality, so just taking it back, ha re qala neng go developa di sexual feelings and how does that influence being a woman?
The sexual feelings di teng mo baneng from a small age, because bana ba banyane ba na le sexual feelings. What they don't have ke emotional maturity ya go deala le di sexual feelings tse di leng teng wa itlhaloganya. So le gantse re le ko re na le bo 5 years, that's why small children can masturbate. It's because the sexual feelings di sa le teng mara ga ba sa tsebe go di address-a hantle in a context ya relationship hantle gore di sebetse hantle.
So what would you say is the good age then re le banana to start informing ourselves ka sex le sexuality?
I think gona yanong from nakwe bana ba banyane ba start obutsang about sex, they can start being informed mara mo aging mo leveling e ba understanding ka yona. But hence ho tsamaya especially ha ho fitla ko puberty, it's okay to start having discussions tsa hore now that we're mensa, it means how ka ba le sexual contact, it you can become pregnant, le go ruta ka di STIs ka HIV and AIDS and so forth. So that becomes age e leng hore it's reasonable enough kuruta bana ba banana haholo.
Okay, but what's then the difference between sexuality le sexual orientation? How is it aware ka these differences?
Okay, sexuality ke when you are sensual, so o kona act a certain way, you ba flirtatious or u feel sexy or u act a bo sexy ke ka action hanga the behavior jwalo. Sexy would be the act of sex itself, sexual intercourse mohlomo. Sexy can be different from kissing, from touching, from fondling, from oral sex, actual sexual penetration. And then sexual orientation ke sexual identity e motho a engang, meaning sexual preference ya gore ba homosexual, meaning that were attracted to batho ba batshwanang le wena same sex, or ba heterosexual were attracted to batho ba opposite sex, or ba bisexual where you are attracted to both people.
I was to me, but outside of the actual physical act really batho ba batsha ba bomme ke eng se re hlokang ho tseba about sex?
Sexy, especially for women, inali emotional attachment e tlang le yona, and that's what people need to be aware of. It doesn't just remain as a physical act, ya u involve emotionally. Why tell me?
Audience members also submitted questions. One of our young ladies asked, at what age should you start having sex?
Ha o lebella hore when is the best age to start having sex? Haina hore e start young mo batho. I would, even when I speak to my patients, I always advocate hore ba abstain for as much as possible and as long as possible. But nakong we tlo ya le emotional maturity ya batho hore wena o mo maemong a majwang, do you feel you are ready for the sexual act? But what's important is re tsebe hore once you become sexually active, it's important to enforce hore there must be the use of condoms to protect yourself. You tell your partner hore ha o jaga mo hai re tshola mo plating, so no condom, no sex. And that's how people must be. So if o feel wena o le ready, part ya maturity le the readiness must also involve hore do you know how to practice safe sex, the use of condoms to prevent unwanted pregnancies, to prevent STIs, to prevent the infection ya HIV and AIDS.
The second one was, how do I prepare myself for sex?
You know, sometimes I joke with my patients and I say to them, if I were to become the president of South Africa, I would say sex without the condom is illegal. And then they look at me and they laugh. But it's because we need to spread message or wahore. If you're going to have sexual relationship, it comes with responsibility. You are responsible for your own life. You don't leave it to the next person to say yena wenze, but how to again like a contract to again amoyon. But you must come with the maturity and the willingness to take responsibility ya who ba engaged in that kind of relationship.
Okay, Austumi, you spoke about emotional readiness, and the third question sort of speaks to that, but can a relationship be successful without intimacy and sex?
Absolutely, a relationship can be successful without sex. Intimacy and sex are two different things. Intimacy is the way batho ba relatang to one another. So ke the way re buang ka teng, re feelisanang ka teng, tsamaisana le di emotions. So you make me feel good about myself, you make me feel comfortable around you, you make me feel like I can share my dreams with you. This is becoming an intimate relationship. You make me feel like I can share my secrets with you, le the things that I'm going through. So you can have an intimate relationship e le hore ha so transfer or e change into a sexual relationship where there's actual sexual intercourse. Remember, sexy lona ke definile hore sexy can vary from kissing agar to touching to fondling to penetration. So kwa kona lor young people can have an intimate relationship mo ba connectang le someone else, and then they can choose hore this is the boundary, the line that we're not going to cross. So you are able to have that kind of, and it can be a healthy relationship.
That was a very insightful conversation. o se ke wa checha re tlo gotla haufi ka mra papatso.
Before the break, we asked the question, when a girl starts her period, what does it mean? The answer is A, she can fall pregnant. How are you, Sislevo, today?
Yes.
So guys, have you a question to ask Sislevo?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my name is Nontokozo Mngoni. My question is, sex before marriage is a sin.
So you want to know if it's a sin?
Yes.
Inkinga yami with that belief, yokuthi sex before marriage is a sin, is the fact that a lot of people feel very dirty about themselves and about something that is very natural. Okay? So I think if it is your belief, it is fine. But I think we must also, and that is my other problem with it, a lot of churches only talk about sex. There's a lot of things that are sins, but people are fine with doing them. Okay? So I don't want to say if it's your belief, it is a wrong belief. I am basically saying the problem with it is when you start having problems with something that is so natural. Ukuthi if uyayenza manje, you are a bad person.
Thank you.
Omunye nombuzo?
Yes.
Naka le butso ke nna mamoketse magotla. Potso ya ka ke hore if ever o le go di protein o be o have sex, it is possible hore o ka ba pregnant.
That's an important question. It is possible. Not gore go unlikely, but it's possible gore o ka fola pregnant. But not only will you fall pregnant, ne? If o le go di protein or o se go di protein o sa sebedise condom, you could also get other sexually transmitted infections, including HIV. So when you are having sex, whether you are in your period or not in your period, is that you must always make sure that you use a condom. Ne?
My name is Bella Maseko. My question is, how do you control your feelings when you have a crush?
When you have a crush? Yo, I wish I knew, you know? I wish I knew. Maybe let me tell you a story about when I was young. You know, when I had my own crushes. So you sometimes when you see this particular person, you sweat, you don't know how to act, you know. Even if mhlambe this person asks you a question, you don't know, you know, ngathi awukwazi nokukhuluma when they start talking to you because you really love them. I think for me, I'm sharing this story with you because it's so normal. You know, when you become a teenager, to really love people in a way that makes you want to melt and oh, your heart, you know, even if you were eating when they come, you don't want to show that you were eating, you know, it's very normal, you know, and you must understand that it's a normal a part of growing up. Okay, so sometimes for me to cope, it was completely avoid them. Make sure that you don't see them. And it's okay if you make yourself a fool. Sometimes it's the opposite. You just want to go to Sundays, you must forever be close to them. And it breaks your heart so much if maybe when I look at Sundays, they are actually interested in your friend or in somebody else. It breaks your heart. But a crush is just like that. It's a crush, you know? It's a feeling that you have. Maybe you dream of yourself in that wedding gown with this guy. It's okay. It's a normal part of growing up. Even if you've made a fool of yourself, accept it. It's fine. We all get through it. I still get crushes even in my old age. Look, this episode was very important because I think the part of growing up, of being a teenager, being a young woman, can be very confusing because we give young women, and I think young boys, a lot of conflicting messages about what does that mean. And some of these things that happen in your body, some of the changes. For an example, when I grew up, my one breast was bigger than the other. You know, you are like, oh my goodness, you know, am I abnormal? When you are young, you also want to fit in. Okay? And I think as Katina Zeningi, we confuse sex and sexuality. Kanti sexuality is the growing up of you into an adult, It includes ama emotions work, or how you feel about yourself. It includes the body changes in you physically. Kanti sex is the act, you know? And in all of this, I think what is important is to make sure that we empower young women about these changes that are happening. But in fact, we celebrate them. When a child crawls and walks, we don't say it's a shameful thing.
Yes.
Do you understand? And developing sexual feelings and your sexuality is also natural. You start menstruating, you start getting interested in sex and stuff like that. For me, it's the same as learning to crawl and to walk. It's your progress as a human being. No pumama zinyo, your wisdom teeth is the same. So for me, celebrate your sexuality, understand that it is very normal, but empower yourself with information. So that for me is what is important about today's episode.
Thank you. It's lovely being here. Thank you.
Okay, my
dear. Oh, today's show, ne? Yeah. today, and the super, and the understand as young woman, would see when it comes to sex, ne? Tina, we see by emotionally attached, you understand? So I think that's what. And to you guys on today's episode.
Well, namhlanje mina ngibone ukuthi nokuthula singabantu and we sexual beings. Ukuzwa imizwa nokwenza ucansi is a natural part of our growth. So kumele ukuthi sivumeleke ukuthi sikwazi ukufunda ngalento, sithokoze futhi ngale zinto ezenzakalayo ngemizimba yethu. Siphinde futhi sikwazi to explore our sexuality. Sibe responsible sikwenza lokho.
You know what, guys? I learned that we can express ourselves sexually, you know, our sexual feelings in another way other than uglalana. Isn't this jal? Isn't that inje?
Yavumelana now yes, opened. Thank you to everyone at home, to our audience, Sis Lebo, Rise Clubs, and my lovely co-hosts. Make sure to join us next week for yet another episode of Rise. Please join the conversation on our Rise Talk Show Facebook page and on Mixed Reach. We'll see you next week.
Woof, woof.